Hello friends, in this video lecture we are going to learn about kinematic analysis of gears. Specifically, in this video lecture we are going to learn about the path of contact of the mating gears. So the content of this video will be path of contact, then on the basis of that we are going to learn about the arc of contact, then length of path of contact, the deviation we are going to see, and then length of arc of contact, and on the basis of all these derivations we are going to solve some problems. Okay, so let us start with the first point, that is path of contact. So you know, when the gears are transmitting the motion from one shaft to another shaft, we know there is the meshing of teeth which are present on the periphery of the wheels. When there is action between the mating teeth, what will happen? One gear, which will be your driving gear, will be imparting the motion on the driven gear. So there is always contact between the mating teeth, right? So therefore, path of contact is that it is a locus of point of contact from the engagement to disengagement of the gear tooth. It means that if you see this particular figure, which is on the right side, so here we can see, if you consider this as pinion, this as gear, let us say this pinion is your say the driving gear, the gear is your driven gear, let us consider. Then if you see, the gear tooth is always drawn between two circles, that is from your base circle to the addendum circle. Base circle is supposed to be your the least circle on the gear, and addendum circle is supposed to be the highest circle or the biggest circle in the gear. Okay, so therefore the teeth are drawn between the base circle and the addendum circle. Let us consider this particular gear. If you consider this, then your addendum circle will be somewhere here. Okay, this way, circular, right, which will be above your pitch circle. So this is your pitch circle, this is your pitch circle, and this is your base circle, this smallest, and one will be over these two circles will be your addendum circle. Okay, so if you see, if you draw the profile of this gear tooth, say from this base circle to the addendum circle this way, let us say this is the tooth on this gear. Okay, so the tooth on the pinion will be somewhere like this, this way. This is the tooth on the pinion. So if you see the first point of contact, so suppose that this E point is your first point of contact, is your first point of contact, and the time at which these two mating teeth get disengaged, let us say suppose this is rotating in the anti-clockwise direction, so this pinion is rotating in the clockwise direction, so therefore this tooth will have first point of contact here and last point of contact somewhere here. Let us consider that the last point of contact is your F while transmitting the motion. So therefore this straight line, that is if you join E and F, this straight line is nothing but the locus of point of contact, and that is called as path of contact, that is called as path of contact. Okay, so therefore definition is locus of point of contact from engagement of two mating teeth to the point at which they get disengaged. That is, that locus is called as path of contact. So to derive the equation for this path of contact, let us consider RA is a radius of addendum circle of on pinion, that is the highest radius of that gear. That circle actually passes through the top of the teeth. Capital RA is radius of addendum circle of the wheel. Say this is pinion and this second one is the wheel. Small is used for pinion, capital is used for the gear or the wheel. Small r is a pitch circle radius or pinion, and capital R is pitch circle radius of wheel. Okay, so let us try to derive the equation for path of contact. So you can see here, when the engagement and disengagement happens, you can see this E to F, this locus is termed to be path of contact. Now this can be divided into two parts, from E to P, that is pitch point, and from again this pitch point to the last point of contact, Okay, so from this starting of engagement to the pitch point, this particular part is called as path of approach. Okay, and from pitch point onwards to the last point where those two gear teeth get disengaged, that is called as path of recess. Okay, so therefore the path of contact is the addition of two, that is path of approach plus path of contact, sorry, path of recess, path of approach plus path of recess. So therefore you can see here this EF is your path of contact, that is the addition of EP plus PF. EP means path of approach and PF means path of recess. Okay, so therefore to derive the equation, let us consider EP and PF separately and then add these two locus. Okay, so now EP, first of all, this if you consider this EP part, so EP part is a part of this triangle BDE. Okay, EP is a part of BDE triangle. Okay, where you can see EP is equal to this entire ED minus this PD. Okay, this total ED minus this PD will become your EP. Okay, so ED minus PD. Now what is ED? You can see here ED. Now ED is a part of or a side of right angle triangle EBD. Why this has become right angle? Because you can see this BD is the radius and this CD or ED is a tangent. So tangent is always perpendicular to the radius. So therefore this EDB will become your right angle triangle. Okay, so ED is perpendicular to BD, so therefore this right angle triangle. So therefore ED, we can find this ED using Pythagoras theorem. So ED will be equal to under root of BE square minus DB square. So we have written here BE square minus BD square. And you know BE is nothing but the addendum circle radius, so RA. And BD is nothing but the base circle radius. And base circle radius is equal to R cos psi. So R cos phi, where this phi is nothing but your pressure angle. Okay, how that has come? R cos phi, we can see here R means your P circle radius. So in this particular triangle, I will write here this triangle. What the triangle? BDP. BDP. If you observe this particular triangle BDP, then you can see this triangle is also right angle triangle. Okay, BDP. This triangle is also right angle triangle. So therefore this BD will be equal to R cos phi. Okay, R means what? Your hypotenuse cos phi. Okay, so therefore we'll put that here, the value of BD, R cos phi square minus PD. Now what is this PD? You can see this PD. PD is another side of this triangle BPD or BDP. Okay, so that will become your sine. Sine component you may say. So therefore PD is equal to R sine psi or sine phi. Okay, so we have written over here, so R square minus R cos phi square, this is in square root, minus R sine phi. In the same way, find the equation for the remaining part, that is PF, that is path of recess. So now what is PF? Now PF is the part of this triangle ACF. Okay, PF is a part of that triangle. So this PF is equal to this total CP minus PC or CP. CF minus CP. You can see here CF minus CP. Again, in the same way, you know this CF is a part of right angle triangle ACF. So again, using Pythagoras theorem, it will be equal to AF square minus AC square. So AF is nothing but your RA, that is addendum circle radius on pinion, that is small RA, minus this will be your R cos phi, because AC is also part of this triangle ACP, this triangle. Okay, so therefore we can write for AC equal to R cos phi. So we have written over here. Minus CP. CP is another side of this triangle ACP. So therefore CP will be equal to R sine phi. Okay, so therefore we have written this equation over here, and addition of these two. See, this equation 1 and this equation 2. Okay, so addition of these two equations will be your path of contact. Path of contact. So therefore, path of contact equal to equation 1 plus equation 2. So finally, we got this particular equation for path of contact. This is that simple. Okay, so remembering this equation is also very simple. Okay, because every term is very simple to understand. Okay, so RS under root RS square minus R cos phi square plus again under root of small RS square minus R cos phi square minus capital R plus small r sin phi. Okay, this is the equation for path of contact. Now, what is arc of contact? So first of all, try to understand the concept of arc of contact. So we have seen path of contact, it was a straight line, okay, from engagement to disengagement of two mating teeth. But see, if we consider the engagement and disengagement on the pitch circles of pinion or gear, because arc of contact is always same for both pitch circle, so this pinion or gear, okay. So it is the locus of a point on pitch circle, okay. It is the locus of point on pitch circle from engagement to disengagement of the mating teeth. Okay, so if you see, suppose this is the first point of contact, okay, and say this is the gear tooth. So I'm going to draw this gear tooth. So therefore, this gear tooth is passing through this particular point. This is not P, but this is some other point of P. So from this point to the last point on the P circle, let us say this is your last point, then this particular arc is nothing but your arc of contact. Okay, so and this arc of contact is equal to simply your path of contact upon cos phi. Path of contact upon cos phi. This is a simple equation. We can easily find out the length of arc of contact. So again, it will be divided into two parts, arc of approach and arc of process, in the same way we have seen in the previous section, that is path of contact. Okay, so therefore then length of arc of contact will be equal to path of contact upon cos phi. So path of approach upon cos phi plus path of recess upon cos phi. So therefore, length of arc of contact will be equal to, we have seen this particular equation for path of contact, divided by cos phi. Okay, now on the basis of these equations, we are going to solve one problem for better understanding of the concepts. Okay, so problem is that a pinion having 30 teeth. Now pinion means what? Small gear. Okay, drives a gear having 80 teeth. It means that the pinion is driver and gear is driven. So small t equal to 30, capital T equal to 80. So we have written over here given. Okay, then the profile of the gears is involute with 20 degree pressure angle. So pressure angle means what? Your phi. So phi equal to 20 degree. Okay, pressure angle equal to 20 degree. Okay, so I must write here phi. This is a phi. So phi is equal to 20 degree. And 12 mm module. So module equal to 12 mm. So small m equal to 12 mm. And 10 mm addendum. So addendum equal to 10 mm. So we'll write over here. Find the length of path of contact and arc of contact. Okay. So now to find out path of contact, let us observe this particular equation. Capital R square, that is addendum circle radius square. So do we have that? No, not directly. But we have only number of teeth. So can you find out on the basis of number of teeth, RA, R, small r, that way? Yes, we can, because we have the definition of module. Module is nothing but T by T, that is diameter, P circle diameter upon number of teeth. Okay, so therefore then we can write the equation D equal to M into T. Okay, we have definition of module, M is equal to, so remember this always, because this is a very important term in the gears, D upon T. It may be your capital D upon capital T or small d upon small t, same way, same. Okay, result will be same, right? So we can use this, and module for pinion and gear same, it must be always same, mating gears. Okay, so M equal to D by T. So we have module, we have diameters, sorry, we have teeth on each gear, we can find a diameter. Once you find a diameter, that divide by 2 is your radius. So same equation is written over here. So R equal to MT by 2, we can see D equal to M into T. So R equal to MT by 2. So small r equal to M small t upon 2. and capital, you can see here, capital R equal to M capital D upon 2. So we got the radius. So this is the radius of pinion and this radius of gear. So we got, okay, when you add addendum to the pitch circle radius, that become your addendum circle radius simply. So RA, that is addendum circle radius on pinion, equal to simply R plus A or R plus addendum. So 180 plus 10, we got 190. So it is addendum circle radius on pinion. In the same way for gear, RA equal to R plus addendum. So we get this 490 as your addendum circle radius on gear. Okay, so now we got everything here. So just put these values over here. Simply using calculator, you can solve the problem. Okay, simply using the calculator, we can solve the problem. Okay, so finally, you will get the final value as 52.3 for this particular problem. And you know, length of arc of contact. Again, we got a very simple equation to find out this length of arc of contact, which is path of contact upon cos phi. So path of contact we got as 52.3 divided by cos phi, cos 20. So you will get 55.66 this value. Okay, I hope you are understanding and you have understood these 2 points, very important points, path of contact and arc of contact on the gears. And through this problem, you must have got some additional information about module, then addendum circle radius. Okay, so thank you for hearing this lecture. Thank you very much.